It's just an honor and privilege just to get a chance just to share what I've learned about contribution over the years. There's definitely a lot of things in the Bible about contribution, and I'm going to give you some things that you can study out, because we can't go through all of them, but just some scriptures for you to write down, and I'll give you the topics, and then I'll share, just what I've been learning lately. But God is serious about his tithe, and you can write down Judges chapter 19 and 20, and you can study that out, and you can see how God responds when his tithe is not given. You know, in Ephesians 4:16, you know, it says the body grows as each part does its work. And you know, each of us here, you know, we've all been in situations where we've either had roommates or friends where they don't pay their part of the rent. Yeah. But they got the most complaints about the house. How come the heat's not working? Why don't we have cable? They eat up all the food and they didn't put anything in the fridge. Now that's none of you. And if you're quiet, it probably is you. We all feel when each part is not doing its work. And we get a little frustrated. You know, I have a scripture here that we've been looking at. Bible talk in Luke chapter 16. And right here, it has the parable of the shrewd manager. It says, Jesus told his disciples, there was a rich man whose manager was accused of wasting his possessions. So he called him in and asked him, what is this I hear about you? Give an account of your management, because you cannot be manager any longer. The manager said to himself, what shall I do now? My master's taking away my job. I'm not strong enough to dig. I'm ashamed to beg. I know what I'll do. So when I lose my job here, people will welcome me into their houses. So he called each one of his master's debtors, and he asked first, how much do you owe my master? 800 gallons of olive oil, he replied. The manager told him, take your bill, sit down quickly and make it 400. Right. Then he asked the second, how much do you owe? Yeah. 1,000 bushels of wheat, he replied. He told him, take your bill and make it 800. Right. The master commended the dishonest manager because he had acted shrewdly. For the people of this world are more shrewd in dealing with their own kind than the people of the light. Wow. I tell you, use worldly wealth to gain friends for yourself, so that when it is gone, you will be welcomed into eternal blessings. You know, there's so many things we get out of this scripture. Right. And one thing that, you know, as we were talking about it, that came out is, you know, it says, what is this I hear about you wasting my possessions? Okay. It comes across to me as the master wasn't as concerned about the possessions, because I don't know anybody who would not notice themselves whether things were short. And I look at that, you know, he went to his debtors and immediately figured out a way to get them encouraged. Right. Now, the thing that really stood out is, how much were they paying before? Wow. That was causing the issue.
Okay. Help us out.
Imagine, you know, you're making collections and you're getting nothing.
Okay.
Absolutely nothing.
All right.
But all of a sudden, this manager figured out how to get in good with the people,
right,
and also to get something for the manager.
Okay.
This manager was extremely talented and knew how to deal with people all along.
Okay, what's up?
See, that's why he was commended, but he still had to be let go.
Okay.
Because he kept what he had for himself. He was lazy and entitled and didn't do what the master wanted.
Oh.
But when he was under pressure, he was able to figure things out immediately.
Oh.
See, interestingly enough, those same people you ever been with that can't come up with their money, but if they need to go on a date, they can get their hair done, they can get new shoes, they can find people. They had it in them the whole time to figure it out. Solutions can come very quickly when you really feel the pressure. But as long as someone was taking care of you, it was completely fine.
Oh.
And you never had to do anything.
Yeah.
See, it wasn't the lack of talent. The manager fired him because this manager, the boss fired him because the manager didn't care.
That's it.
And the entitled person will never be unentitled.
Yep.
You know, we just shared some things that have been going on with the church, which unfortunately it is shameful.
Yeah, it is.
That we have our lives saved. Things completely turned around. You know, each of us has shared how much we've been pulled out of the fire at different times. We've each been encouraged. But yet, God has no place for his people to meet. Because we can't figure it out. We've chosen not to. You know, we all like to enjoy and we all like to have more. But the question is for ourselves. You know, some of us may feel, we're chilly in here. We wish the heat was on.
Okay.
Well, what part of the work are you going to do?
Right.
Come on, bro. Come on, bro.
Or should it be just provided for us? You know, some of us are in different situations where we are given the best we can, and that's all. And God is absolutely fired up with that.
Come on, bro. Yeah.
Some of us are doing less than what we can, and some of us aren't doing anything.
Right.
That's just the reality. The question we each have to ask ourselves is, what do we want?
Right.
Now, one thing I want to share with you, something that I've learned from being an entrepreneur, there's a big difference between being an employee and being the boss. The difference is, well, if I don't find work, I don't have work. And the landlords usually don't care. But what I've learned from being an entrepreneur is a secret that I think each of us want to know. How many people want to know how to get a raise at their job? A significant raise. Good. Good. Well, this is how it's done. You want more, you got to give more. The same way it works in your own house. When the person, you know, how come there's no food in the fridge? We want more food. Well, go get more and there'll be more.
Right.
Same thing on your job. All jobs are the same. Everything works in America based off of profit, revenue, cost. So if you're someone who's struggling saying, hey, I'm not making more money, ask yourself a simple question. Do you even understand what your job does? And how they generate revenue.
All right.
See, most of the time, us as employees who can be very entitled,
you're right.
Lots of times we don't even know.
Right.
All we know is I clock in and I clock out.
That's
sort
it.
Of like sometimes we do at church. Oh. I clock in and I clock out. Imagine if you're the boss at your job and I clocked in and I clocked out, right? And I did the same job. For the first year, right? But at the end of the year, I said, give me more money. I don't do anything more.
Yeah.
I don't generate one extra penny.
Yeah.
So just think of a pie. The pie is a certain size, right? I want a bigger piece. But I don't do anything to generate more. You do not get raises at your job or significant raises at your job if you do not increase profit. Period. Your raise has already been pre-budgeted. This is every job.
Yeah.
It's been pre-budgeted.
Yeah.
They're gonna tell you whatever they're gonna tell you. If it's 2%, they've decided that 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Every job, monthly they have a meeting, and it's a financial meeting. And you know what they're discussing?
Okay.
Is Noel really worth his weight?
Yeah. Yeah, true.
Why do we keep paying him? Oh, well, he did this, this, this. Okay, we'll pay him. That happens at every one of your jobs.
Yeah.
Why? Because monthly you're doing expenses and you have to pay bills. And every time you pay bills, even if you're getting along, I get along with Princeton, he's awesome, but I just paid a bill and it's like, what has he done lately?
Right.
Do we actually need him?
Right.
No? Okay, all right, we keep him.
There you go.
So the simple formula, if you want to figure out how to generate more, first you figure out how do they make money? So if it's retail, they're selling things. Have you found out what their marketing plan is?
Come on, Noel. I like it.
If it's a restaurant, do you know what people like? Are you helping them with their online advertising? Are you doing anything that's going to generate more? Because if you generate more, then you don't ask for a raise. You ask for a piece of the increase you're bringing in.
Wow.
And that answer is always yes. There's a difference between... And the reason why I'm saying this, I know sometimes we struggle. We want to understand, how do we make more money? How can I get more money? It is very simple. If you ask for a piece of the increase, that's not the same thing as asking for a raise. Asking for a raise, the person is thinking, even though they're going to say, oh, you're nice, you entitled brat. Because you worked here for 3 or 4 years doing the same thing, not generating more, I should just give you more? Wow, that's entitled.
Wow, there it is, bro.
Well, what happens when I've been a disciple for a very long time?
Wow, there you go.
God, I've been benefiting for years and years and years. And since I've been benefiting for years and years and years, God, you owe me more. So how come I don't have the same job as that person had? How come I didn't get married like that person did? Does that make any sense to us? We want more out of the kingdom, but we don't want to put more into the kingdom. So, now, afterwards, we can definitely talk individually if you want. We can get into more specifics. I was being very generic. But yes, we can help you figure out how to start generating more money.
Yeah.
But what it still requires is a different attitude. You can't have the attitude of the lazy manager. You can't have the attitude that everything is supposed to be there. What will be there is what you're willing to put into
it.
And that's in every part of your life, especially in God's kingdom. You're going to have the kingdom you're ready to build. And if you look, one last thing, if you look through the Bible from beginning to the end, you see that God changed his tone just to answer you. When you look in the beginning, in the garden, God created it by himself, and therefore there was rebellion. In heaven, God created it, and therefore there was rebellion. When you look at Israel, even though he gave them the land, he made them fight for every inch of it. Because God was teaching us a lesson. You will not do anything for what you did not fight for. That's why you will not receive anything, even as a disciple. You know, people say, God has granted me victory. Yes, he has, but you will fight for every inch of it. Because what you don't fight for, you will not appreciate. So God will not give it to you. With that, I mean, I definitely would like us to pray. And I really would like us to all think about how we can do more in each part of our life so that we can produce the very things that God wants us to have. And with that, I'd like to pray. Dear God, I'd like to thank you for this time to get together and just to reflect on what we have and what we've been given. God, I pray that we each take personal account of what it is that you've given us, what it is, whether it's our talents, our abilities, our opportunities, where we live, our circumstances, anything that we can work at and we can show you how much we appreciate what you've given. God, we know that you will give the increase. God, we know that you will bless our efforts, so that I pray that we will have efforts to be blessed. God, I pray that we will all be unified in a desire to see your kingdom grow, to see your kingdom be great. God, to see an awesome place for our family, our friends, and our children. God, I pray that we will be that light on the top of the mountain that everyone can look toward.
Yeah.
God, I pray that you bless the contribution today.
Yeah.
I pray that each person, as they put in, they will put in with a great deal of joy, encouragement, and faith.
Yes, right.
God, and I pray that we each remove the sense of entitlement in our own hearts. We love you. Pray this just in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.